This video is a masterclass on reading data from command line.
Hi, my name is Nahid. I'm a professional software engineer. I want to help you master tools and techniques of modern computing one video at a time. Let's dig into today's content.
I will cover three types of input, how to pass in program arguments, how to interactively read data from the user, and how to pipe data into your program. First up, let's have a look at how to take in program arguments. For example, we have been compiling our programs using GCC. Here, GCC is the program. The strings after the program are called arguments. This is what the full main function signature looks like. Your main function can have two parameters, an integer called argc, short for argument count, that tells you how many command line arguments are passed in, and an array of C strings called argv, short for argument values, that contains the actual arguments. Let's print out the arguments. So I'm printing argc here, and I'm looping through the arguments to print the C string of the argument. As you can see, you get one argument even when you don't specify any arguments. At index 0, we have the name of the program. Let's pass some arguments in. Now we have 7 arguments. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. What if I wanted to put A, B, C together? I simply get rid of the space. And if we wanted to put everything together, I can make this into a string with quotes. As you can see, just 2 arguments. First is the program name. Second is the string we passed in. So part 2. How about we try reading some data input from users? Let's say our program needs to know the user's name and their age. Let's say the name is 100 characters max and age is an integer. The way we do this is using the scanf function declared under the CSTDIO header file. This works similar to printf. It takes in a format to say the format of the data we want to take in looks like this. And instead of a list of values, it takes in a list of pointers to variable so it can load data into those. Here is an example. Looks like this is exactly what we need. So something like this. In format, we are saying give us a string. And we are passing in name, which is an array, which is a pointer. And in the second case, we are asking the age. We are reading in a number, so that's percent %d. And we are passing in the pointer. Let's also print. So this will print the name and age. Let's try this out. There you go. Finally, let's show you how to pipe data into your program. If you are a complete beginner, you probably don't know. One of the most powerful things you can do in the command line is string together multiple programs. What I mean is, for example, you can load some data using one program, process it using a second program, process the output of that using a third program, and then save the data into another file, all using one line of command. I don't know how much of that I'll be able to do in Windows, but let's find out. For this, we're going to use the getchar function. This reads the character from stdin. I've defined an int to store a single character. That's because the return type of getchar is an int, where it might also give us a special value called EOF. Let's use a do while loop to keep things neat. This will loop endlessly. Let's get the character. If the character is EOF, we want to break out of the loop. Otherwise, let's print out the hex of the input character. This is how you say to print using at least 2 digits, pad with 0 if necessary. All right, let's run this. I can type in some gibberish. And as you can see, it prints the hex of whatever I type in. I can stop this using Control C. Now let's try some piping. Let's read our source file in. So that's cat read.cpp. As you can see, it read in our source file. And I can pipe that into my program. So this should be the hex of my program.
If you like this content, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. All questions, comments, requests, and feedback are welcome. I will see you in the next video.